Hey guys, welcome to Heather Together, the channel where we work together to get our poop in a group. Today we're going to be talking about the dreaded road trip with small kids. My family goes on a summer vacation every year, and this year we're embarking on a 16-hour road trip with our small children in one vehicle. So I definitely have been thinking about activities to keep them entertained. I always say the key to a great road trip is good snacks, planning, and fully charged iPads. But we know the iPads are not gonna last the whole trip, and we don't want our kids on technology for 16 hours. So, while movies are good for a little while, here are some activities that I have learned over the years. I travel a lot with my kids by myself because my husband's work schedule. So we go on small trips to see family, and people ask me how I do it with them being little. But really, I just get in a routine, I do it. It's not a big deal to me anymore, but here's some tips that I've learned. So when they were very little, I would give them dry eraser markers and boards and let them write and let them play. Or I would give them crayons and coloring books. I would also let them use the dry erase markers on the windows of the car because it wipes right off and it comes off of everything except their clothes, but they're probably not in their Sunday best, right, when they're traveling. So I would let them do that. They also thought it was fun because it was something that they really weren't supposed to do. So they thought they were getting away with something by writing on the windows. But again, it wipes right off. You can put some window cleaner if you really want to get all the residual off, and you'll never know. But as they got older, they didn't want to color anymore. But I still want them to do some kind of art in the car to keep them entertained. So I found these little scratch art books. You've probably seen these, but if you haven't, they're really great. They come with a little stylus that holds right in the book. And you start out without a picture. You start out like this with blue. And you slowly take the stylus and you just scrape, 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 scrape away. And it reveals a picture underneath. So this one, the theme was cars. So there's all kinds of different vehicles. The theme was vehicles, I guess. But there's all kinds of different ways that you can use transportation within this one. So they come with different themes. This one was for my little boy, but there are ones for girls as well. So I usually pick up one of each. It keeps them entertained for quite a while. The old magic marker ones that I used growing up, those usually reveal the picture really fast and you're through with it. These will keep them busy for a while and there's not a lot of mess. There's a little residual from the scratching off, but it's not a big deal. Chances are your back seat's gonna be crazy looking when you get to where you're going anyway. Mine always is, no matter how clean it starts out. So another thing that I have found that I use, this scavenger hunt. This is a great little thing. I found this at Target. It comes with a bunch of different cards, and you give the kids 5 to start off with, and as they find something, they get a new card. And then at the end, of course, whoever has found their whole stack wins. There's all kinds of things. So you can see dog in the car, find a bald man, license plate numbers that are on a license plate, a man with a mustache. You know, there's all kinds of different things, but they use different senses as well because there's smell something stinky, hear a siren, and then there's things for in urban areas as well. So not just on the interstate, but there's like find a mailbox, find a stop sign, things like that. So that really keeps my kids entertained and they love it whenever they find something. Another fun thing to do is bring board games that don't have a lot of pieces. The tried and true Guess Who game. This just flips up, the pieces don't fall out, there's not a lot of cards and moving parts. So this keeps them busy in the car as well for a really long road trip. I have a little one that likes to sew, and so I also put together a little sewing kit for her. She likes to quilt, so I bring her some quilt pieces and she sews those in the car. Not a lot of mess, you just a little needle and thread and some safety scissors, and she's good to go. This keeps her entertained making quilts or little clothes for her stuffed animals. It keeps her really busy. So that's another fun activity as well. For educational things, we're gonna be actually going through 9 states on our trip. So I print off a little bit about each state. This is a fun activity because it teaches them. I have the state flag, the state capital, the state motto, when it was founded, the state bird, state flower, things like that. You can pick all kinds of things to teach them about. But when we get to the state line of that state, they get to open up a new envelope. So I cut them up and I put each state in here that we're going to be traveling through. And so they get to open that up and learn a little bit about each state along the way. It's a fun way to keep them entertained, keep them looking at the road, but also it teaches them something about each place that we're going to be visiting along the way. So the key is try to be, minimal in the car, because there's usually not a lot of space and you don't want a lot of moving parts around. But you definitely don't want to be hearing, "Are we there yet? Are we there yet?" over and over and over. And, you know, kids are in their car seats now, they're strapped in, whereas I used to walk around the car. We had a huge van. But being strapped in, it's restricting. So they don't get to get up and stretch a lot. So unless you're going to take a lot of breaks and get out and maybe go in and eat at different places, make sure you bring some good snacks and keep them hydrated, but not too much, because you don't want to be stopping every 2 hours to use the bathroom either. I have found that. But also, just remember, planning is the key. Keep it fun. Let them take a lot of naps. If you have one that gets car sick, like my son does, we always keep plastic bags in the car, and children's Dramamine is a must. I give them half a dose because it will just knock him out, because that's what Dramamine does, but that keeps him from getting car sick and lets him enjoy the trip a lot better. So iPads, games, art, education, sewing, anything you can think of, just try to keep them entertained, and that's what I'm gonna try to do on our road trip that's coming up. I would like for you to leave your comments below on how you keep your kids entertained in the car. And also, I would appreciate it if you would subscribe, and we will tackle another topic on the next video. Until then, please click subscribe, and I will see you later. Remember, there's joy in every day. You just have to look for it. Take care. Subscribe.